How's it going, everyone? It's Javi here. I thank you guys for watching as always. And today is August 18th, 2018, about 11:20 o'clock at night, so it's pretty late, and we're going into the 19th basically. But anyways, let's start to look at what's going on in the Atlantic and the Pacific hurricane season. So as of right now for the Atlantic, you could see no tropical cyclone activity is expected for the next 48 hours. And last report, I was talking about Ernesto and how that was going to bring high winds, heavy rain, and probably some localized flooding in the Ireland and United Kingdom region. But now the system turned extra tropical. It already has hit, as the westerlies basically just took it. So it's nothing to worry about as of right now, since it turned extra tropical. We're going to shift our focus to the Pacific, where we do have some activity like we've had all year. We have obviously Hurricane Lane, which is currently a 140 mile per hour storm, central millibar pressure at 948, which is a lot, which is something that a lot of the computer models didn't expect. And it did strengthen a lot more than expected from what the computer models originally expected. And we have disturbance one still has a small chance of developing over the next 48 hours, and it has an even smaller chance 5 days later, which is 10%. Before it was 20%, but now it seems like the odds are evening, and they're kind of low, the odds for this storm to develop. And I'm gonna show you why. We just have an abundance of dry air ahead of this, where I'm pointing my mouse right now. We basically just have this small upper level low, it seems like, that's bringing a lot of sinking air with this, and it's going to affect its development and bring some stronger wind shear. So it won't really have an environment where it's conducive enough to develop. So it seems unlikely that this thing is going to develop. And as for Hurricane Lane, it's obviously a very strong storm, but if you start to look at the satellite imagery, you can see that it has a visible eye. But then over the past several runs of the IR map, you see that the eye kind of dissipated, which shows a sign that it's probably going through an eyewall replacement cycle, which the good news is that it should weaken it, and I don't think it's gonna ever recover from that eyewall replacement cycle for like other hurricanes, because like I mentioned before, you could see that ahead of Hurricane Lane, there's a lot of dry air, and hurricanes don't usually like dry air when dry air basically invades the hurricane, because when dry air starts to spiral into the low pressure, it brings more sinking air, and it's more difficult for that air to rise, because the dry air with its higher air pressure usually, and as it spirals towards the hurricane, it kind of hinders the hurricane from really getting a true convection, since a lot of that moisture that's trying to rise is being basically blocked by the dry air. So as a result there's not as much convection, not as much thunderstorm when dry air goes to these hurricanes, and as a result there's a less strong storm with less hurricanes creating that convection and instability. But you could see that Hurricane Lane has a pretty tough road ahead, as you can say. You see that there's going to be a lot of dry air, and there's going to be increased wind shear with this upper level low you see just north of Hawaii, and this huge upper level low that's near Alaska at this point, and that's going to hinder its development quite a bit as it tries to move towards the west. And I'm going to show you the projected path of this. You can see that it's expecting to move west, and like I said, it's going to gradually weaken from a category 3, category 2, and then by the time it reaches around the longitude of Hawaii, it should be weak enough where it won't bring any tropical storm force winds. And also, you can see the wind field isn't very large with this, so, and the cone is still a couple, maybe even 100 miles away from the middle of it. But like I said before, like the cone of uncertainty doesn't mean that the middle is the most likely. It's basically anywhere in this cone it could hit. So, but even if it takes the most northern track of the cone, maybe the southern tip of Hawaii could get tropical storm force winds, but that's about it. I don't expect much impacts in Hawaii. It should say just weak enough and just south enough where I don't expect any tropical storm force conditions. And the wind field as the storm weakens is probably going to get smaller also. So it's unlikely that Hawaii will even experience tropical storm force winds from this storm. But it still should experience high surf. So if you're a surfer in Hawaii, this may be a good middle of the week surfing time, because you obviously have a hurricane or possibly a strong tropical storm that's just going to be to the south of Hawaii. But in terms of impacts, it should be limited, mainly high surf, rip currents. So be careful if you're along the beach in Hawaii, and it shouldn't be much of a threat, kind of like what Hector was. But Hector, obviously under Hawaii, was a category 3 hurricane. This is probably going to be a category 1, maybe even less than that. So it should gradually weaken, which is definitely the good news that it should miss out on the Hawaii Islands. And that should be about it for Hurricane Lane. And as for the Atlantic, there's just nothing going on in the Atlantic. No tropical cyclone development, as we're basically in a pattern in the Atlantic where everything in the Atlantic is mostly sinking air. So any type of low pressure that tries to basically retain its strength or trying to get organized is basically just going to be hindered by a whole lot of sinking air. And I'm going to show you a map right now. And you could see in the Atlantic, there's really nothing. You could see there's no type of convection or no type of thunderstorm activity in the middle of the Atlantic, and very little thunderstorm activity in the main development region. And you could say these thunderstorms are a little bit south than usual. Usually the main development region is a little bit up more north, but it's a little, these thunderstorms are a little bit too far south to really gain rotation and to really start to spin, which is one of the key factors to creating a tropical cyclone. Because when thunderstorms are too far south, then the Coriolis effect is very weak around the equator, so the hurricane doesn't really have its spin if it gets closer to the equator. And that's what's happening right now. We just have a very dominant high pressure ridge of high pressure that's basically just so big and so dominant that it's basically blocking any thunderstorms from entering the main development region right here. So it's just a whole lot, there's just a whole lot of sinking air. You can see that most of the rising air is in the US right now. And in meteorology, most people should know that if there is rising air in one location, there has to be an equal amount of sinking air in another for the weather to be as balanced as it could be. So you could see that it seems like the highest pressure is in the Atlantic right now, which is definitely good news since there's no tropical cyclone in development over the next couple of days, and it should remain that way based off of the computer models. You could see that the European doesn't really have much to say in terms of Atlantic tropical cyclone potential development. And it's just gonna, you could see that there's no type of convection even 10 days from now, as we're just gonna be stuck in a dry pattern in the Atlantic, which is definitely good news. So I guess that's all I have to say for this video. I thank you guys for watching. There was not much to talk about, to be honest, but I thank you guys for watching. As always, make sure to subscribe if you want to see more, and I hope you guys have a good night or a great day.